So it was here, we have to solve here the value of VC, IC and VO with respect to time. This is the RC circuit we have studied in yesterday session. So here when switch will be at position B, we can see 12 and 18 kilo ohm are in series and then they are parallel with this 64 kilo ohm. So firstly, we can derive the value of time constant. Tau is equal to RC. C ka value hume pata hai, yahan pe diya hai 0.1 microfarad. But yahan, instead of one resistor, there are three resistors. So we can calculate here R equivalent. So here, when you are calculating R equivalent, when you are calculating R equivalent, 12 and 18 are in series. So 12 plus 18 equal to 30 kilo ohm. That will be in parallel with this 60 kilo ohm. So you can calculate 1 upon R equivalent equal to 1 upon 60 plus 1 upon 30. So you will calculate R equivalent equal to 30 into 60 upon 30 plus 60. You will get the value of 20 kilo ohm. And that is the value of total resistance, or we can say it is the R equivalent resistance. We have to calculate tau. Tau is nothing but time constant. So tau equal to total resistance into C. C ka value hai 0.1 microfarad. So we can take 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 6. And resistance ka value mil raha hai 20 kilo ohm. So 20 into 10 raised to 3 ohm. So if you calculate these calculations, after calculating, you will get 2 milliseconds value. So this is the value for time constant. Now what we have to do? We have to calculate VOC. This is nothing but voltage appeared across the capacitor. And when we are taking the initial condition t equal to 0, at that time we are supposed to consider capacitor as a open circuit and inductor as a short circuit. We have seen this in all previous session. So what we have to calculate here, we have to calculate voltage across this capacitor. So we can keep this capacitor as open. हम इसको ओपन सर्किट कंसीडर कर सकते हैं. तो हमें सर्किट क्या मिल जाएगा, 90 वोल्ट, 50 किलो ओम एंड 10 किलो ओम, एंड दैट सर्किट विल बी ओपन. यू कैन सी हियर दैट सर्किट इज ओपन. सो वी कैन कैलकुलेट द वोल्टेज अपीयर्ड अक्रॉस दिस कैपेसिटर, एंड द वोल्टेज अपीयर अक्रॉस दिस कैपेसिटर विल बी वोल्टेज अक्रॉस दिस 10 किलो ओम, बिकॉज दिस आर इन पैरेलल और पैरेलल में वोल्टेज सेम होता है. सो we can calculate the value appeared across this capacitor by using the voltage divider rule. So when you will get t equal to 0 and switch will be at position A, that time at initial condition capacitor will behave as the open circuit, and you can calculate voltage appeared across this capacitor by using voltage divider rule. So voltage divider rule se tum kaise calculate karoge, 10 किलो ओहम जिसके अक्रॉस का वोल्टेज निकालना है वो अपॉन टोटल रेजिस्टेंस. टोटल कितना है यहाँ पे, बोथ आर इन सीरीज, सो 10 अपॉन 10 प्लस 5, दैट विल बी आई कैन टेक डायरेक्टली एज अ 15 किलो ओहम, एंड दैट वैल्यू इज इन 90 वोल्ट. यहाँ पे किलो है, यहाँ पे किलो है, किलो किलो विल गेट कैंसल. सो आई हैव टेकन ओनली द वैल्यूज 10 अपॉन 15 इंटू 90. सो यू विल गेट voltage appeared across the capacitor will be 60 volt. When switch will be at position A. Now what we have to do? We have to calculate after switching. This is the voltage before switching. So we can say here, हमें जो 60 volt मिल रहा है, this is the value of voltage appeared across capacitor before switching. So value of voltage appeared after switching, that will be, we can calculate as a VC 0 plus, and that will be same because capacitor will store the some amount of charges, and when it will go to the discharge, it will take some time, and that time we are taking as a 0 plus. That is the instant when switch will go to the position B from position A. Position A se position B pe jayega, tab yahan pe jo voltage tha, we are getting here 60 volt voltage. We have just calculated. So when that switch will go to the B, for some instant that voltage will remains here. So we can take here V 0 minus equal to V 0 plus, and that will be 60 volt, because when capacitor will go to the discharging position, it will take some time. So at instant after switching, after switch will go from A position to the B. At that time, we are getting here voltage as a 60 volt. So what we have to do? Now we have already calculated time constant. यहाँ का time constant हम पहले ही निकाल चुके हैं. Now we can use directly the equation. So using voltage divider rule, we can calculate voltage across this. We can calculate voltage across this capacitor. So we can derive according to the voltage divider. So we can calculate. We are having the formula. That is nothing but we are having Vc of t equal to V. V is nothing but input voltage. और यहाँ पे input voltage कितना आ रहा है हमें? 60 volt. So we can take 60 volt e to the power minus t by RC. RC का value हमने कितना calculate किया है? 2 milliseconds. You can see here. I will again show you. तो का वैल्यू हमने कितना कैलकुलेट किया है? 2 मिलीसेकंड. और हमारा इक्वेशन क्या है? VC equal to V into e to the power minus t by RC. तो RC का वैल्यू है 2 into 10 raised to minus 3. तो 1 upon 2 into 10 raised to minus 3. You can take 500 directly. So I have taken here directly the value. Minus 500 into t. क्योंकि 1 by RC का वैल्यू है 1 upon 2. Into 10 raised to minus 3, उसका वैल्यू मुझे आता है, मुझे मिलता है 500. And if you are calculating the output voltage, if you are calculating the output voltage, that will be appeared across this 12 kilo. So we can calculate according to the voltage divider. 12 upon 12 plus 18, because we are using here voltage divider. Into total voltage, and total voltage is 60. You will get that voltage as a 24 volt. But this is the voltage which will get across that resistor. But we are here supposed to calculate the value of voltage because of resistor as well as because of capacitor. So what we have to do? We have to use our formula. And our formula is VO of T equal to VI. So that voltage is nothing but 24. Into e to the power minus t by RC. फिर से 1 by RC को मैंने directly minus 500 लिखा है. Into t, that hold. Again, you are supposed to calculate the value of current. So if you are calculating according to the Ohm's law, you will get I equal to V by R. But here, we are not calculating the current only because of resistance. We are supposed to calculate the value of current because of resistor as well as because of capacitor. So we are having the formula. Which formula we are having? We are having the formula I equal to current into e to the power minus t by RC. And you can calculate current by using the formula Ohm's law. V kitna hai tumhare paas yahan pe? 60. So you can calculate 60 upon that resistor. Yahan pe jo resistance ka value aata hai equivalent, that resistance you can take, जो तुमने R equivalent का value निकाला है. This is the 20 kilo ohm. If you calculate, you will get that value as a 0.03. So I have taken here directly that value. So we can calculate IC of T equal to I into e to the power minus T by RC. So you will get minus 0.03 into e to the power minus 500 T ampere. These A, V, these are the units. Voltage, and this is the ampere. So this is the equation how we are solving the value of voltage appeared across capacitor, current flowing through the capacitor, and voltage appeared across the load resistance. We have to use this formula. We are calculating here this thing for the normal response because they have given here. You are supposed to consider here switch will be, the switch has been in A position for long time, and at time t equal to 0, when switch will go to the B, at that time we are not considering this initial voltage. So we will supposed to calculate this voltage and current for normal response. So we have taken the formula Vc of t, Vc of t equal to Vi into e to the power minus t by RC. But if we are supposed to calculate these things, when switch will be at position A, at that time we have to consider this initial voltage also. And at that time we can call this response as a steady state. और उसका फॉर्मूला क्या रहेगा वोल्टेज का? The formula will be Vc of t equal to Vi of t into in bracket 1 minus e to the power minus t by RC. Difference क्या है वहां पे? सिर्फ यहाँ पे Vi के बाद में e to the power minus t by RC ले रही हूँ, वहां पे Vi into the into bracket 1 minus e to the power minus t by RC. In this form there will be equation. Or current ka equation kya rahega? Same, there will be only difference is there will be the positive sign. There will be the difference in sign. When we are supposed to calculate the value for the steady state, and this we have solved for when switch will be at position A, means at position B. Ye yahan pe diya hai. At time t equal to 0, switch will move to the B. And at that time, we are calculating. Switch jab B ke position mein jayega, at that time, we are not considering this voltage. We are considering only this circuit. So we are calling this is the natural response. In today's session, we will study about the RL circuit. So you can see here we are having the RL circuit in which only resistor and inductor are used. Consider the following circuit for which switch is closed at t is less than 0. If t is less than 0, we are saying switch is closed. Means what? We have to consider this energy source also. We have to consider that value of current, and we are saying then opened at t equal to 0. When time will become 0, at that time we are making that switch is on. So we have to consider only this RL circuit, because when switch will open here, that circuit will get open. So no need to consider this resistor and this inductor. So the DC voltage has been supplying RL circuit with constant current for the long time, because they have given here energy source as a current source, and here we have to derive the equations for voltage and the current. So if you are considering t is less than or equal to 0, what we are saying, if t is less than or 0, at that time switch is closed. And when t will become greater than or equal to 0, at that time switch is open. Switch will become open. Switch jab open ho jayega, we are supposed to consider only this R and L. We cannot consider this energy source, and we can call this as a normal response. And if we are closing that switch, we have to consider this energy source also, or hum usko bolenge steady state response, or we can say it is the forced response. Forced kyun? Because hum yahan pe external energy source bhi de rahe hain RL circuit ke alawa. We are considering here current value also. So 0 minus is, it is the denotation, it is used to denote the time before switching. And 0 plus, it is the denotation which is used to denote time immediately or instant after the switching. So we can apply here KVL to calculate the value of voltage. Firstly, we will derive voltage, then we will get the equation of current. So if you are applying KVL to this circuit, so what can we do here? We have to apply KVL to this side and this side. If you are writing equations, you will get V of t plus Ri of t, because here is the resistance or yahan current hai. If we are deriving the current, if we are applying the KVL, you can write in the form of voltage. So yahan ka voltage rahega, that will be V equal to IR. So you can write here V of T plus यहाँ का जो रेजिस्टर है that value into current equal to zero because according to KVL algebraic summation of the voltage will be between closed loop will be zero. Across closed loop if you are calculating the summation of the potential drop that will equal to zero. So when we are applying to the loop one, if you are applying to the that loop, you will get R into I of T plus here का वोल्टेज, यहाँ जो करंट की वजह से जो वोल्टेज जाएगा V at time T that will be equal to zero. And if you are applying KVL here, you will get the equation R into I of T plus L di by dt. Why we are taking L di by dt? Because if there is a conductor at that time, there will be electromagnetic flux will get induced due to which EMF will get induced. And the value of EMF will be minus L di by dt. So the same value but only having negative sign. That will be the voltage across this inductor. So we can take that value as L di by dt. So for a second loop, we will get equation L di by dt plus Ri of t equal to zero. We can rearrange this equation in the form of L di by dt equal to minus Ri of t because here we have to derive the equation of current. So main kya kar rahi hu? Right side mein jo hai, we are writing here the form of, in the form of time and here in the form of current. So we can rearrange this equation and we can write di of t upon I of t and L will go to the this side minus R by L and ye dt jo yahan denominator mein hai, it will go to the numerator. So you will get di of t upon I of t equal to minus R by L into dt. So these equations we are getting. Now what we can do? I am writing again same equation. ओनली मैं वहां टाइम का नहीं कंसेप्ट लिखा है मैंने यहाँ पे टू मेक अवर सोल्यूशन सिंपली दैट्स व्हाई आई हैव नॉट रिटन हियर यू कैन राइट एज इट इज आल्सो इफ यू आर सपोज टू राइट दिस इक्वेशन यू कैन टेक एज इट इज नाउ व्हाट वी हैव टू डू वी कैन इंटीग्रेट ऑन बोथ साइड बिकॉज वी आर सपोज टू कैलकुलेट हियर इक्वेशन फॉर करंट सो व्हेन वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग एंड वी आर टेकिंग द इंटीग्रेशन आर बाय एल इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट So we can take minus R by L outside the integration and you can put T0 to T time and you are taking integration of dt and here this side I of T0 to I of T because you are considering time from T equal to T0 to the T equal to T. So you can calculate here integration di by I. So you know how to calculate the integration. So di by I is nothing but it is the log I if you are taking the integration. So you can take here log I or you can write ln also. This is nothing but the logarithm. So I of t upon I of 0 because you have given their limits. Tumne t equal to 0 se t equal to t ka limits diya tha. And minus R by L constant term. Aur dt ka integration kya hai? T. So you can take as it is. So if you are not supposed to write in the form of logarithm, what we can do? We can anti-log. We can take anti-log. If you are taking anti-log, you will get here I of t upon I of 0 equal to. And that equation will go to the E square. E ke upar chale jayega. Because you are making here anti-log. So yahan pe kya ho jayega? Exponent. So e to the power minus r by l into t. You can write in the form of I of t. I zero ko main ye side mein leke jaungi. So I can write our equation I of t equal to I of zero into e to the power minus r by l into t. But this is the equation for current flowing through the inductor when we are making switch off. When we are making switch off and if you are making switch close at that time your equation will be I of t equal to I of 0 into one bracket 1 minus e to the power minus r by l into t. So this is the equation for curl. So now we can calculate the value of time constant. Time constant is nothing but it is denoted by tau, and tau is calculating the rate at which current or voltage approaches to zero. Because we know when we are seeing these equations, we can see here current value is exponentially decreasing with respect to time. Matlab time jab zero hai, at that time we are getting maximum amount of current. Voltage ka bhi equation hum RC mein dekh chuke hai, wahan pe bhi kya tha, VC of t equal to VI of zero e to the power minus 1 by RC. Yahan R by L ke wahan kya aata tha, minus 1 by RC into t. So we can say the value of current and voltage are decreasing exponentially with increase in time. So here we have to derive the time constant, and it is defined as it is rate at which current or voltage approaches to zero. So for RC circuit we get the value of tau equal to RC. और हमें इसके लिए क्या मिलता है, RL के लिए we will get the value of time constant equal to L by R seconds, because this is the time constant, so it will be measured in the second. So you will get tau equal to L by R second. Now we see all equations. So the expression for the current, voltage, power and energy. Energy means work done. I have written here equation for work done also. So I of t we have just derived. I zero of t into e to the power minus t by r tau, or you can write here minus t r by l, because l by r yahan aata hai, to r tum upar ke side likh sakte ho numerator mein. So you can write I of t equal to I zero into e to the power minus r by l into t, or you can write in the form of tau. The value of Vt equal to, you can write in the form of Vi of t, or you can write according to Ohm's law, Vi of t ko maine kya likha hai, I0 into R. This is the total resistance if there are multiple resistance. Aur ek resistance hai, to wahan pe jo resistance rahega uska value. Aur yadi zyada hai, to we are supposed to derive the equivalent resistance. We can derive by using the series combination or the parallel combination rule. Jaise wahan pe diya hai waise. सीरीज में रहेगा तो डायरेक्टली एडिशन लोगे, एंड इफ इन पैरेलल यू कैन टेक मल्टीप्लिकेशन इन न्यूमरेटर एंड इन डिनोमिनेटर यू आर सपोज टू टेक एडिशन ऑफ दिस रेजिस्टर. सो वी कैन राइट पी ऑफ टी इक्वल टू आई जीरो आर इंटू ई टू द पावर माइनस टी बाई टू, और यू कैन राइट वी ऑफ टी इक्वल टू वी आई इंटू ई टू द पावर माइनस टी बाई टू. एंड नाउ वी नो टी पावर इज नथिंग बट वी इंटू आई, सो यू कैन राइट इन दिस. Again, we can calculate work done. So work done will be 1 upon 2 into L I0 square in bracket 1 minus e to the power minus 2t upon 2. This is the work done. So we can see here for all transient cases, the following instant we are using with respect to time. T equal to 0 minus, we are considering this is the instant before switching. So it is from minus infinite to the infinite, or it is the time before switching. T equal to 0 plus, it is the instant after switching. So time after T equal to 0 second, it's initial condition. And T equal to infinite means it is the time after switching. It means what? If there is some amount of time after switching, it means what? This is the time of switching between t equal to 0 plus to t equal to infinite. Matlab iske baad ka, the instant after switching we are calling as a 0 plus. But after that, if switch is switch, we have made switching. And after that, if there is a change in time, then we can say that time is in between t equal to 0 plus to the t equal to infinite. And this is the time of switching. The illustration of the different instant of switching time. Before switching, this is the x-axis, this is y-axis. We are taking time on this x-axis before switching t equal to 0 minus. After switching, we can take t equal to 0 plus. Now we see one example. What we have to do here? This is the RL circuit. You can see here. For the given below circuit, find the expression for output current which is flowing through the this resistance, because the output ke yahan pe ek resistance diya hai. We have to derive output value of voltage that will be flow through this resistor, and the switch was closed for long time. Long time means we have to consider t equal to 0 plus to t equal to infinite. So here the switch was closed for long time, and when t equal to 0, switch was open. Matlab jab t equal to 0 hai, at that time switch is open, and when will be switch closed? If we are taking long time, if we are taking after t equal to 0, if we are taking some time and that time is infinite, at that time we can say switch was closed. So here we have to derive the value of voltage and capacitor. So in first step, we can calculate firstly time constant. Find the value of time constant for t is greater than 0. And what we are saying, when t is greater than 0, at that time switch is closed. So draw the equivalent circuit, and when t will be greater than 0, they have given at time t equal to 0, switch was open. So firstly, we have to derive the value of total resistance. So we can see here, what we have to do? We have to calculate the value of resistance. When we have to calculate? When we are making this switch open. When we are making this switch open. At that time, inductor we are supposed to consider as a open or short circuit. Can anyone tell me? Initial condition mein inductor ko hum short consider karenge ya open karenge? Priyanka, please unmute yourself and answer the question. Please answer the question. Pranali.
Yes, ma'am.
When I was supposed to calculate the value of time constant, at that time we require the value of L by R. L by R hume chahiye. So uske liye firstly we have to derive the R equivalent. So when I have to derive this R equivalent, just tell me how we have to consider this inductor. Inductor ko main short consider karungi ya open consider karungi?
Okay. Short, ma'am.
Very good. Okay, you can mute yourself. Okay, so what we have to do? We have to calculate here time constant. So there is no need to consider the value of this. We only have to calculate the value of this resistor. So you can see the value of 2 ohm is in series with 10, and that will be in parallel with 40. So we can take, you can see here. So 2 plus 10, because they are in series, and that will be in parallel with 40 kilo ohm. 40 ohm hai ya 40 kilo ohm hai? 40 ohm hai. So what? 2 and 10 are in series, so we can take addition. 12. 12 will be in parallel with 40. So we can calculate RT equal to 12 into 40 upon 12 plus 40. You will get value RT equal to 10 ohm. We are supposed to calculate the value of tau. Tau ke liye hume yahan pe L ka value diya hai. What is they have given? 2 Henry. So we can take L by R equal to 2 upon, we are getting total resistance 10 ohm. 2 upon 10 equal to 0.2 second. So this is the value for time constant. Actually in the question, they have not given. For the time constant, there is no need to derive. But in calculations, when we are supposed to calculate the value of voltage and current, at that time in equations, we are needed the value of time constant. So, wo calculation simple karne ke liye hum kya kar rahe hai? Tau ka value pehle hi derive kar rahe hai, and we can take the value of tau in that equation. Tumhe aise derive karna, you can derive, or you can derive in directly in the इक्वेशन ऑफ वोल्टेज एंड करंट तुम वैसे भी कर सकते हो. सो इंस्टेड टू व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, व्हेन टाइम इज जीरो माइनस, इट इज नथिंग बट टाइम फ्रॉम माइनस इनफिनाइट टू जीरो माइनस, स्विच वॉज क्लोज फॉर लॉन्ग टाइम. So we know inductor will behave as a short circuit. So now we can see here 20 ampere will flow through this resistance. So we can calculate the value of IL when time is at 0 minus. At that time this inductor is behaving short circuit. So current ka jo value hai pura wo isme se jayega. Same value will go. So you will get current 20 ampere will flow through the short circuit until switch is not becoming open. जब तक switch open नहीं है तब तक हमें same ये current मिल रहा है. So I can take IL 0 minus equal to 20. So now I can use current divider rule to calculate the value of current. So by using the current divider rule, the current in 40 ohm, because in the question they have given, we are supposed to calculate the value of output current. Question mein unhone kya diya hai, we have to derive the value of I0 of t. So we can derive I0 of t. So at the instant when switch is open, thus current flowing through the inductance will remain same, and that amount will be ye jo 20 ampere tha ye we can take here in inductor, because we needed only that much circuit, because at that time switch will become open. So hamare paas itna circuit aa jayega. When switch is open hame yahan ka current mil gaya hai, but that current is incoming current. At the ye input current lenge, this is the current which is flowing through the inductor, but we are supposed to calculate current flowing through that resistor. So we can take IL 0 minus equal to IL 0 plus, and that will be 20 ampere, which is the initial current. Since there is no other supply in the circuit after switch is opened, this is the natural response case. Because here when switch is open, we are not considering the value of other energy source. Ye jo current diya hai, we are not considering. We are only considering this circuit. यहाँ का इंडक्टर we will consider, because जब स्विच तुम्हारा ओपन हो जाएगा at that time यहाँ ये इतना ये करंट और ये रेजिस्टर we will not consider, but we have to consider this circuit as it is. तो हम ये सर्किट as it is consider कर रहे हैं. We are getting the value of current. IL 0 minus मिल गया, IL 0 plus मिल गया. So now I can apply voltage divider rule to calculate the voltage, to calculate the value of current flowing through 40 ओहम. 40 ओहम के लिए मैं करंट डिवाइडर रूल यूज कर सकती हूँ. व्हेन वी आर यूजिंग करंट डिवाइडर रूल, यू आर सपोज टू टेक टोटल करंट इनटू द पैरेलल करंट दैट इज इन न्यूमरेटर, एंड इन डिनोमिनेटर यू आर सपोज टू टेक एडिशन. वोल्टेज में क्या लेते हैं हम, जिसके अक्रॉस का वोल्टेज निकालना होता है वो लेते हैं, बट करंट डिवाइडर में वो नहीं लेना है रेजिस्टर न्यूमरेटर में, जो उसके साथ पैरेलल में है. वी आर सपोज टू टेक दैट वैल्यू. So we can take 10 upon 10 plus 40, that will be 50. 10 upon 10 plus 40, that will be 50 into total current which we will getting here. So that value is nothing but 4. So we can calculate I equal to minus 4 into e to the power minus 5t, because this is the formula we are having for value of current because of resistor as well as because of इंडक्टर. ये जो करंट था वो हमने सिर्फ रेजिस्टर के वजह से जो जा रहा है उसका वैल्यू डिराइव किया है. सो वी आर गेटिंग दिस 4 एम्पियर. यहाँ ये जो इफ यू विल कैलकुलेट 20 इंटू 10 अपॉन 10 प्लस 40, यू विल गेट हियर माइनस 4. यू आर गेटिंग हियर माइनस 4. यहाँ पे मैंने 20 नहीं लिखा है, बट इफ यू विल राइट हियर 20 एम्पियर यू विल गेट हियर माइनस 4. सो इफ यू कैलकुलेट दिस इज द करंट फ्लोइंग बिकॉज ऑफ द रेजिस्टर. यू आर सपोज टू कैलकुलेट बिकॉज ऑफ रेजिस्टर एज वेल एज इंडक्टर. सो यू आर हैविंग द फॉर्मूला I0 ऑफ t इक्वल टू I of t into e to the power minus r by l t. बट मैंने यहाँ पे ऑलरेडी एल बाय आर का वैल्यू डिराइव किया है टाइम कांस्टेंट का एंड दिस इज द एल बाय आर इज 0.2 सेकेंड सो 1/0.2 दैट विल बी 5 सो आई हैव टेकन हियर डायरेक्टली वैल्यू 5 सो वी कैन टेक वैल्यू -4 इनटू ई टू द पावर -5 टी नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू ओम्स लॉ वी कैन कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ वोल्टेज यहाँ का जो करंट है -4 इनटू वहाँ का रेजिस्टेंस लास्ट में कितना लोड रेजिस्टेंस दिया है 40 इफ यू आर कैलकुलेटिंग यू आर गेटिंग द वोल्टेज -160 बट दिस इज बिकॉज ऑफ रेजिस्टर वी आर सपोज टू कैलकुलेट बिकॉज ऑफ रेजिस्टर एज वेल एज इंडक्टर तो हमारे पास इक्वेशन है v0 ऑफ t इक्वल टू vi ऑफ t इनटू e टू द पावर -r / l t r / l का वैल्यू मैंने डायरेक्टली 1/0.2 था टो का वैल्यू सो वी कैन टेक हियर 5 डायरेक्ट So 1-160 into e to the power -5t. Mathematicals है इतने जल्दी समझ में नहीं आएगा You have to practice by your own. ये जो मैं PPT share कर रही हूँ उस मैं आज क्लासरूम में PPT share करूँगी ये सभी और my live lectures also I am sharing on YouTube and in classroom also. You are supposed to go through these lectures. Then only you will understand the things. Now here we have finished. RL circuit. So now we can see these are the differences between RL and RC circuit. In RC circuit, we are getting time constant equal to RC. And in RL, we are getting time constant equal to L by R. Inductor will behave as a short circuit when supplied by DC source for long time. And when we are supplying DC source for long time, capacitor will behave as an open circuit. Inductor current is continuous. But voltage across capacitor will be continuous. So वहाँ पे voltage जो है before and after switching same था यहाँ पे current जो है same है. So these are the differences between RL and RC circuit. Now I am taking your attendance. If anyone is having any doubt, you can ask me. Now we can conclude our today's class. You guys can leave. Thank you.